Stauffer back again for another cooking demonstration. Today we're going to be doing soft shell crabs. Picked up two crabs today here at the market, and I'll tell you a little bit about them. These are jumbos, typically soft shell crabs as you get them. They're in different sizes. The biggest ones are called whales. These are jumbos, and then there's mediums and then primes. Typically crabs come in and they shed their shells by molting, and typically over a full moon. We just had one here, and so the crabs are just starting. I was quite impressed when I went to the market today and saw we had some soft shells available. So let's go over first and show you how to identify which is a good one. When they shed their shells, when they pull them out of the water, as you can see, this guy's still moving, he's alive. They have to pull them out of the water right away so that the shell will not get hard right away. So they set them into a little bit of a cardboard box with some straw in it, and they cover it up to keep it moist. First, when you get a crab, this is a female crab, as you can see, with a large apron here. Well, what we're first going to do is we're going to clean the crab. There's certain parts that we don't want to eat. Everything else we can. So we're going to cut off the face of the crab. We're going to take the apron off here like this. Then we're going to flip it back over. Keep the claws attached. These are the gills right here. We want to remove the gills. So you can see we're taking these off right here. We don't want the gills under each flap. Pull those off, okay? That crab's, and right here inside, this is like the part we call the mustard part. We pull all this out. So this is a side. And you can rinse these if you wish, or set them aside. So we're going to do the other one really quick. Again, we have another female crab. We're going to pull this off. If this apron was not as wide, it would be a long, pointy one. That would be the male crab. The females have the wider apron like this to hold the eggs when they're having their big eggs in there. Okay, we're pulling this off again. That comes out, and again, we're taking your finger and just kind of sweeping out this inside part, so that's ready. Now we have, this is finished. Next, what I want to do is, normally I would clean all this up, but I'm trying to do for demonstration purposes how to do this quickly. We're going to add the crab into an egg mixture. We're going to batter them up, get them ready. Now you can do flour, or I use this time Bisquick to put that in. So coat them in egg. You can do egg and milk or whatever you wish. And we're going to coat them on both sides. And then after they're finished, we're going to put them over here. I'm going to get my pan on medium high, so that's getting hot a while. Again, we're going to get this other one here ready to go. Coat him up, or rather, get this crab ready. So we have two crabs ready to go. Let me rinse off. So when the crabs molt, so there we go, get all those extras off there. Like I said, the crabs molt, and they catch them in a trap. And they're actually called peelers. And they take those crabs, they see them, they're getting ready to molt. A real true crabber can identify them very easily. And then they'll put them into, they're above water, and they have these boxes. They're about as wide as my island here, and they're real long, and they're covered over top so that birds can't get in and eat them. And they typically molt at night, so the workers are walking up and down constantly looking for the crabs. As soon as they walk out of their hard shell, they're now a soft shell crab, and that's when you want to pull them out. Now, once I have this crab ready like this, we have them here. So what I will do is a couple things you can do. Sprinkle a little Old Bay on them if you like. Give them a little extra Old Bay. Or another one is, I have this really good, it's a garlic and wine seasoning that I got from a restaurant called The Melting Pot. So this one I really like. You can can sprinkle some of this on too to give it a little extra flavor. And you eat the whole thing when it's finished. So we're gonna, over in the pan, we're gonna put some butter in. If you don't wanna use butter, you can use olive oil. So we're gonna melt this butter up. You could add garlic if you like. And then we're gonna gently just place these crabs in here and let them saute up a little bit. So they're over there in the skillet. We're gonna cook those crabs for about 4 to 5 minutes, 4 to 5 minutes per side. And that will turn out really nice when they're finished. So as you can see, the crabs are cooking in here like this, and it will be finished shortly. Hope you enjoyed learning how to make a soft shell crab. You will see them pretty much through the spring here in the summer. They will stop shedding their shells at one point. They'll shed a couple times, and that's how the crab gets bigger, by shedding their shells and growing into a bigger crab. We always love the Maryland crabs as they get bigger, more plumper. I was almost ready to go buy a dozen today. But then the softshell crab caught my attention, so I thought we'd do that. Let's get this. I'm sure you'd like to see the end result. Let's give you one more look here. See, as I flip this over, you can see they're getting a little brown. We're going to need another 2 or 3 minutes on the other side, and then I'll have my nice soft shell crab dinner. Thanks again. Hope you enjoy.